where this is played. I think that's actually, I think the Republicans are happy to debate the FBI all day long.
And we are going to take a break from CBS Network coverage of the Brett Kavanaugh hearing on Capitol Hill. We will return to that momentarily when the hearing continues. Right now, we'll take a break for News 3 at 5 as a former nurse accused of intentionally harming his patient was in court today.
Christopher Capum is at the center of a patient abuse scandal at Meritor Hospital. Keely Arthur first reported this story, and she shares the latest.
That's right. Disgraced nurse Christopher Capum is facing 19 felony charges of child abuse and intentionally harming babies inside Meritor's NICU. The alleged abuse of his infant patients spans nearly a year and includes injuries of bruising, broken bones, and a skull fracture. Capum appeared in Dane County Court today for the first time, where he was ordered to stay away from the 9 alleged victims, their families, and the Madison Hospital. He is out on signature bond and was booked at the public safety building. We caught up with him as he left.
Do you have any comments? Are there more children involved?
What
about the families of the victims?
In silent, as did his defense attorney. Meritor told News 3 this today, quote, "We recently learned that the legal process is moving forward regarding our newborn intensive care unit. We have supported the legal process throughout this investigation. There is no doubt that as an organization, we all remain devastated by what happened." A total of 9 babies were determined to be injured by Capum, and why this happened really remains the big question. No motive given in that criminal complaint.
All right, Keely, you'll be following this story. Thank you very much.
Dr. Christine Blasey Ford told a Senate panel today she is 100% certain that Supreme Court nominee Brett Kavanaugh sexually assaulted her when both were in high school. He denies those allegations. Ford described to senators the night she says Kavanaugh sexually assaulted her. Blasey Ford said she was terrified that Kavanaugh was going to, quote, accidentally going to kill me after he put his hand over her mouth to stop her screams. Blasey Ford told the panel she struggled with the decision to come forward, but felt it was her responsibility to tell the truth.
But the details that about that night that bring me here today are the ones I will never forget. They have been seared into my memory and have haunted me episodically as an adult.
Judge Kavanaugh was sworn in this afternoon, telling the panel he did not assault his accuser or anyone else. He was given an opportunity to respond and answer questions from the Senate Judiciary Committee after they heard from Dr. Blasey Ford, who accused the Supreme Court nominee of sexually assaulting her during high school.
This onslaught of last-minute allegations does not ring true. I'm not questioning that Dr. Ford may have been sexually assaulted by some person in some place, at some time. But I have never done this to her or to anyone.
Kavanaugh said he will not be intimidated into withdrawing his nomination to the Supreme Court. Blasey Ford requested not to be in the room for Kavanaugh's testimony.
Local demonstrations have been happening around the nation in response to the Kavanaugh hearings.
A group of protesters here in Madison gathered outside Senator Ron Johnson's office to share powerful stories of survival and in hopes to ignite change. Our Jamie Perez shows us up close and personal these accounts made today. She joins the news center with their stories. Jamie.
Well, so often survivors of sexual assault have their accounts denied or rejected. They have them hiding in their own minds. They have victims building stairways in their heads to escape the reality and magnitude of what happened to them. This gathering that I was at today was a demonstration of support simply by others telling them, I believe.
We're gathering in solidarity with survivors.
Survivors. It's a word that carries a level of strength.
So many of us here are survivors.
Loving what they did here today.
We are not objects. We are not playthings. We are not the butt of people's jokes. We are humans, and we deserve dignity and respect.
But hating why they have to do it.
This is not a path to celebrity, and it rarely leads to our abusers being held accountable for their actions.
The story shared.
I was afraid of how he would react knowing I had said something.
And I woke up and the lights were out. And he was rubbing his penis against my leg. And my pants were off and I felt paralyzed and I felt like I couldn't move. And the only thing I could say was, please don't, I'm a virgin.
the things that led them to it.
I did not report because I did not want to be seen as a victim.
Every story hard to hear.
He made several uncomfortable jokes about me owing him good sex after having spent so much money to take me on this trip.
But with every story,
this is something that's going to have a huge impact for decades to come,
comes a reason why they stayed silent.
We might not want to be labeled as a victim. We might not want to make the situation worse. We may want to forget it ever happened.
And it's not just about the victims.
Who hasn't been sexually assaulted? A show of hands, who hasn't? That's all I want to know. That's all I want to see. Let's get that down on TV.
It's about changing history.
We believe survivors.
We believe survivors.
We believe survivors.
After sharing their stories this afternoon, they all signed a letter addressed to Senator Ron Johnson, urging him to vote against Kavanaugh. They took that letter and chanted into his office, handed it to one of his staff members in hope to ignite change. These women all have a message and one final one they wanted to leave us with, and to make sure you go vote. They say that your voice matters.
All right, Jamie Perez in our news center. Jamie, thank you very much. Now, if time allows, we'll have more local headlines in the next hour or so if News 3 at 6. If they have a break in the hearings, for now, we return you to the Kavanaugh hearings on Capitol Hill, CBS network coverage.